Fiber broadband provider Converge ICT Solutions set to offer contract-free FiberX plans. Converge said this new offer is designed to cater primarily to consumers residing in multi-dwelling units, such as condominiums. It will allow new customers to enjoy high-speed and unlimited fiber connectivity without any hassle. Converge Executive Vice President and Chief Commercial Officer Benjamin Asada says, "The new term plan is perfect for renters as it removes the worry of their connectivity contract period not being in line with their rental contracts. The contract-free plan goes for as low as 1,500 pesos with speeds of up to 1 Gbps. The previously dovish Philippine Central Bank governor now douses hopes they could begin to cut rates in their policy meeting next week. Let's get the details from Lady Vicencio, who joins us on the line. Hi, Lady.
Yes, Denise, the Monetary Board may keep interest rates steady on its next policy meeting after headline inflation picked up last July. Banco Central ng Pilipinas Governor and Monetary Board Chairman Eli Remolona Jr. said the BSP is less likely to cut interest rates as inflation accelerated to 4.4%. The central bank earlier hinted of a possible rate cut sometime in August or October as inflation settled within the government's 2-4% target range in the first half of the year. But Remolona said the recent inflation number was slightly worse than expected as it breached the upper end of the government's target. The central bank chief also sees the U.S. Federal Reserve cutting interest rates in its next meeting on September, but he suggested they are not in a hurry to cut rates in its monetary policy meeting next week. Remolona also said they are open to an off-cycle action depending on the data coming in and open hopes for a rate cut if there's a slowdown in economic growth. Denise?
Thanks for that, Lady. Citron Corporation. Its first half top line grows to 444 billion pesos thanks to improved operations here at home and in Malaysia. Sales volumes in the Philippines were up to 44 million barrels, while it was at 24 million in Malaysia. In all, that's 69 million barrels, higher by 20% year-on-year. Next, the DMCI Holdings, its net income down 29% to 11 billion pesos in the first semester. That's on lower contributions from its coal mining, on-grid power, as well as real estate units. DMCI says, though, contributions from its water and off-grid segments help mitigate these impacts. As for Philippine Business Bank, net income reaches 1 billion pesos, an improvement from the 870 million last year. Total assets also expanding to 155 billion pesos. Finally, to Alliance Global's brandy and whiskey maker, Emperador, first half net profit declined to 3.8 billion pesos year-on-year, while revenues were down to 28 billion as it admits the Philippine market remains challenging, reflecting the global situation. Some changes in the Philippine Stock Exchange composition set to take effect on August 12th. Here are some notable movements. In Jepsia II's Double Dragon and digital entertainment firm DigiPlus will be part of the PSE's mid-cap index starting next week. Cebu Air and Shell Pilipinas 4, meanwhile, will be removed. The industrial index also seeing additions with renewable power firm Alternergy, as well as Rojas & Co. Incorporated, together with food and beverage company RFM Corp. As for the property index, the Villar family's Vista REIT is set to join. It's worth noting, though, that none of the current 30 blue-chip stock companies will be removed from the PSEI, nor will there be any new additions.